Algorithmically, it's pretty straightforward to do this, all right? We start off at any point in time, we have a set of particles at the last time step, and each particle has a state, like its position, and a weight. And we're also going to be given a new action, like take a step to the right 2 meters, and we're going to take a new measurement. And then here's how the particle filter runs. We start off with a new set of particles empty and a normalization constant of 0. Makes sense. And then we just do the following n times, where n is the number of particles that we need, all right? So the first thing we do is we sample a particle from the previous distribution, that's from this distribution here, according to its weight. Okay, so we just sample a particle, okay? The next thing we do, this is actually a combined step, okay? It says control, but it really should say control and diffusion, right? We sample a new state using two things. Whatever the old one was, so that's the value we pulled from the particle, right? That's this xt here. We've sampled a particle. It has a particular state. That goes right in there. We also have the action. And then we have to sample from the new distribution. So let's suppose the action is take a step a meter to the right. Every time I do this, Megan goes, all right, take a step a meter to the right. And then I'm going to sample from a distribution because there's actually some uncertainty about that step, right? That's our process noise. So it's a little tight Gaussian. I generate a little bit of noise and I add that. That's what this sampling value is here, using the previous sample, the control, and then whatever the noise is, okay? Then what I do is I reweight that sample. What do I weight it by? I weight it by how likely would the measurement have been, this is my likelihood, okay? How likely would that measurement have been if that new sample is actually where the object was or where the robot was? That becomes my new weight. All right? That's the multiplication step we did before. We took our prior, we had those lumps, we multiplied and got them through. We just keep track of the sum of those weights. We add that particle to our growing set of particles, and we do this n times. Now we're all done, except one problem. Our weights don't sum to what? They don't sum to 1 because they were whatever they were. We just did this multiplication. So all we have to do is, because we've been keeping track of the sum of the weights, that's the eta, we divide all the weights by that value. That's normalizing the weights. When we're done, we have a new distribution, bunch of particles. Each particle is at a particular state. Each particle has a weight, and the sum of those weights is 1. And so that's a valid sampling-based representation of the probabilistic density. And that's it. That's all of particle filtering.